Let's take up the topic of revaluation of assets and liabilities, which comes under the lesson admission of a partner. Now, first of all, revaluation. Now, whenever a partnership firm is reconstituted or whenever a new partner is admitted into the firm, at that time the value of the assets and liabilities should be revalued. Right? Now, it may happen that some of the assets might have decreased in value or appreciated in value, or the same case like liabilities have decreased or increased. So whatever the case may be, so at the time of the admission of a new partner, the assets and liabilities should be revalued, and the profit on that revaluation should be shared by the existing partners, that is the old partners, right? So it is in the interest of the old partners as well as the new partners to make the revaluation account and share the profit on revaluation or loss on revaluation accordingly. Fine. So first of all, you should understand that this revaluation is to record the increase or decrease in the value of assets and liabilities at the time of reconstitution of a partnership firm or when a new partner is admitted. Right? The profit or loss on revaluation is shared by the partners in the old profit sharing ratio. Right? Now let's see the format of the revaluation account. I'll make the revaluation account. The debit side, amount, and credit side, right? Okay, now here on the debit side you will have two assets account. Now all the assets will be written individually, right? And this is for decrease in assets value. So whenever there is a decrease in the assets value, it will come on the debit side. Two liabilities. Now this is when there is an increase in the value of the liability, right? Then two liabilities, again I'm writing. Now any liability which is unrecorded will be coming on the debit side. Finally, two profit on revaluation transferred to the old partners in their old profit sharing ratio. Okay. Now on the credit side you will have buy assets. Buy assets, and this is increase in the assets value, right? Then by assets we have written, we'll write by liabilities, that will be a decrease in the value. Okay, so here I'll write by liabilities, and this is a decrease in the value of the liability. Fine. Then whatever is the loss that will come on this side, before that any unrecorded asset that will come on this side, unrecorded asset will come here. And finally, by loss on revaluation, so if it's a loss, it will come here, transferred to the old partners, again in the old profit sharing ratio, right? So this is how the revaluation account will be prepared. Now before taking up a question on this revaluation account, I would like to put down the journal entries also for this revaluation. On increase in the value of the asset, the journal entry will be asset account debit to revaluation account, right? Then on decrease in the value of the asset, it will be revaluation account debit to asset account, right? Then we come to for decrease in the value of liability. In some of the questions, they might ask you to make the journal entries also, so you should also know the journal entries and then how the journal entries are transferred to the revaluation account, right? For decrease in the value of liabilities, it is liabilities account debit to revaluation account, right? For increase in the value of liability, it will be revaluation account debit to liabilities account, like this, right? Then transfer of profit on revaluation. So here it is, if it's a profit, it is revaluation account debit to old partners. Capital account, right? If it's a loss, transfer of loss on revaluation, here it will be old partners capital account debit to revaluation account. Okay, so these are the journal entries that have to be passed, and I have already shown you the format of the revaluation account. Now I'll show you a small question in which you'll be preparing the revaluation account. Supposing, let me put down the question here. A and B are sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2, right? Okay, now their balance sheet is given. I'll put on the liability side of the balance sheet first. Creditors is given as 40,000, and you have the capitals of A and B. For A, the capital is 36,000, and B it is 24,000, right? So the total capital is here 60,000. This is your liability side. Now I come to the asset side here. Okay, in the assets we have cash in hand, that is 10,000, debtors 20,000, stock is 12,000, furniture is 18,000, and buildings is 40,000, right? This is the balance sheet. Now after that, it's given C is admitted with 1/5 share in the profits, right? He brings rupees 15,000 as his share of goodwill, and here a provision for doubtful debts is to be made for rupees 3,000. Buildings and furniture are revalued at rupees 38,000 and rupees 16,000 respectively. Okay, creditors were likely to claim only rupees 35,000. Now this is the question. You are supposed to make the revaluation account first. Okay, so let's start with the revaluation account here. Okay, now first of all, I'll go back to the question. Buildings and furniture are revalued at 38,000 and 16,000 respectively. I'm taking up the second point, right? Buildings, the actual value is 40,000. It has come down to 38. So that is a decrease, right? Same way, furniture, the actual value was 18. Now it has come down to 16,000. So in both the cases, it is reducing by 2,000. So the assets are reducing by 2,000. There is a decrease in the assets. So it will come on this side. Two, buildings account, that will be 2,000. Same way, two, furniture account, 2,000, right? Provision for doubtful debts is a liability, right? Provision for doubtful debts is to be made for rupees 3,000, means you have to, that is an increase. There was no provision earlier, now you have to create a provision, that is a liability. That liability is increasing, so that again will come on the debit side. You will write two, provision for doubtful debts, that is 3,000 rupees, right? Okay, then one more thing is there. Creditors were likely to claim only 35,000. Now the amount of creditors that is given here is 40,000, right? Out of, now we are saying that only 35,000 will be claiming, right? So that means there is a decrease in creditors. So decrease in the liability. So decrease in the liability comes on the credit side. So it is by creditors, and it is decreasing by 5,000 rupees. So that will come here. Okay, so here there is a loss on revaluation. So here you see the total is 7,000. 7,000 here, 7,000, 7,000. So this will be a loss on revaluation, which will be shared. So by loss transferred to A and B, right, in the ratio of 3:2. So this is 2,000 rupees. 2,000 rupees will be shared in the ratio of 3:2. So that will come to 1,200 and 800. So this is how you prepare the revaluation account. So with that, I come to the end of today's topic on revaluation of assets and liabilities. Bye.